What are some of the advantages that Pulse Secure brings to the table? There are, obviously, it's a crowded security space. There are a lot of vendors offering a lot of different products and services. What are some of the advantages that Pulse Secure would bring to the table if you're considering?
Absolutely. So when we think about our role in the enterprise, we look at it as how do we enhance productivity of an enterprise securely? So when you speak about other security companies, I'm not coming into a customer saying I have an endpoint security solution or a network security solution or an antivirus solution. I'm coming in saying I understand your productivity needs in a world of growing requirements for you and shrinking budgets for you. Mm-hmm. And so my innovation is to enable you to thrive in that environment, but do so securely. And why is that more important today than ever before? For two simple reasons. Mobility drives freedom and therefore drives productivity, but creates security challenges. Cloud creates more options and optionality, but it comes with its own security challenges. So how do we enable you to exploit those two capabilities securely? That's where we come in and offer solutions to customers.
I mean, you mentioned it just right there. There are so many transformations happening right now in the enterprise space, mobility, the migration to cloud, right, to cloud deployments. What are some of the really sort of novel or interesting applications of the Pulse Secure suite of technologies that you see in your customer sites?
Definitely. So first things first, we take a platform approach to everything that we do. Mm-hmm. So let's take with the most basic example. I mentioned we have 20 million users of our technology. The client software that sits on, whether it be a Windows laptop or a Mac OS system or an Android device, etc., that is common across applications. So when it comes to how easy it is to deploy Pulse solutions, let's say you're a traditional customer using us for remote access, but now you want to provide mobile security and mobile access. You don't need to change the client. All you need to do is do something at the administrative and a policy level. Equally, if you want to deploy certain SaaS applications and provide single sign-on to your enterprise users, you don't need a new client and you don't need to set new policies with third parties or in the cloud. So ease of deployment, integration of these various disparate islands, but doing so securely without compromising your policies and enriching your policies, in fact, is our differentiation.
So, you know, we kind of talk about security like it's monolithic and it's the same for every company, but as you know, it isn't, right? So small enterprise, very different than large enterprise.
Absolutely.
From budget to network infrastructure and so on. Folks are watching this conversation and wondering, how do I get started with some of the initiatives, some of the types of projects you've talked about? What's the best way to do it?
So first things first, we provide options to customers. You mentioned the size of customers and the deployment needs of customers are very different. Mm-hmm. So for instance, some customers, especially as it relates to security products, to help them dimension things better and scope things better, they like appliance form factors.
Right.
And so we support that. There are others who have, as an enterprise-wide policy, said, I want to be only in a virtual environment. So we provide that option to them as well. And there are yet others who are hybrid, as in I want some in the cloud, some in the data center, I want the freedom to orchestrate. So we provide that capability as well. So what was largely a hardware-oriented company in the Juniper days, we have evolved it to support virtual and cloud in everything Pulse builds. That's number one. Number two is providing centralized management and policy, where a large customer may say, I want it on-premise because I want total control, mm-hmm. versus a smaller customer may say, I want the comfort and the flexibility of the cloud. So we provide them policy and management, both from the cloud and on-premise. And last but not least, we provide various business models, because you have to innovate in the business model as well, with regards to consumption-based licenses, subscription, mm-hmm. perpetual models, and help customers pay as they grow, so to speak, and give them the options of CapEx versus OpEx.
I mean, it's interesting, there are so many, the transition between on-prem to cloud, but most companies, of course, are somewhere in between, right?
Absolutely.
So they've neither committed entirely to the cloud, nor have they completely staying with on-premises.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So the way I like to describe that trend to customers is, we are in the business of extending your data centers mm-hmm. into the cloud mm-hmm. at a pace that is convenient to you. Because as you can imagine, if I'm a brand new customer today or a brand new entity, I may have the option of going all into the cloud.
Startups.
Yeah, but most companies, let's call it 98% of the companies, have already got a form factor, which is in the data center, and now they're looking at how do I leverage the cloud. And so what you need to show them is not a way to rip and replace things, especially with their security, and instead show them a hybrid model which leverages their existing investments in infrastructure, gives them the comfort of knowledge that they've gained with policies over the years, mm-hmm. and then extend it to the benefits of the cloud, which is what we are in the midst of doing.
Sudhakar Ramakrishna, thank you so much for coming on and talking to the Security Ledger. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you, Paul. Pleasure having you.